Tibetan medicine emerged from the traditions of ancient Chinese medicine and Ayurvedic medicine from India. Dr Amchi Tsetan is the last living descendant of the oldest family to practice Tibetan medicine. For the first time, Dr. Tsetan has accepted to give an interview about his life, his practice, and the future of well-being. The foundation of Tibetan medicine is the relation between the body and the mind.
So once your mind is sick, your body is sick also, because thing is, when you are too much stress on, you cannot breathe well, first things. And when you cannot breathe, you cannot think well. So when you don't think well, and then there is also tense of all this, what's called this depressionness. So when you are depressed, so naturally you are tired, and then you will be get tired, and then you are all sick because you cannot breathe well, you cannot eat well, you cannot sleep well. So this is the destruction of even to grow older.
But in our world, it's very difficult to don't be stressed. What do you think?
Yeah, there is a way of taking, for example, like in Tibetan, what we say is like rebong nam Tibet dungem. It means like one who do every daily life, like the sky is going to fall on his head, like a rabbit. So since a rabbit is kind of an emotion person, which always construct all the negative emotion into their heads, so they are always worried, they are not able to stay comfortably. So whereas like a pig is concerned, they can stay, they can eat, they can sleep, and even you just kick a little bit, they will just move, and they never think of being tense. So they live actually better life than a rabbit. Though rabbit is more beautiful animal. Okay, so life is like that.
The relationship between the mind and health is not a new concept for traditional Tibetan doctors. In recent years, neuroscience has aimed to shed light on this intricate relation.
We're realizing that there's a convergence, increasing convergence between the new science of consciousness and what has been claimed by spiritual traditions from around the world since millennia. So the brain is connected to all the major physiological systems of the body, including the immune system.
For example, it has been illustrated that feeling anxiety has a direct effect on the body at the cellular level.
What's happening in the brain when we're stressed or anxious is basically an activation of what's called the reptilian brain. It's responsible for our responses to fear. So it takes in information from the environment through our sensory organs, and in the case of anxiety brought about without an external stimulus, it's activated just by our own thoughts. So our own thoughts, which are equal to perceptions, essentially, will activate these lower reptilian aspect of the brain, which includes the amygdala, which everyone is pretty much familiar with, and we get this overactivation of that, which causes all these chemicals to be released, which will create this response that will either be fight or flight. So you'll either want to run or hide.
When you are too much tense, when you are too much emotionally stressed, you know, it carries more than you are relaxed, because it's like when you are relaxed, the immune system and all the things that works well, so there's like rejecting others. So when your emotion is weak, I mean, then immune system doesn't, I mean, develop. So it's like carrying even like a small, what's called cold and covered, all these things is because of your immune system doesn't work well. Well, you could, you know, I mean, you could cure the things if you took regularly the medicine, and also the how to live with the diet, and also like doing a lot of pronations, because we have this pronation is kind of to stitch the body, and also to what's called to offer your body to Buddha Dhamma Sangha, as well as to, I mean, for the circulation of the blood also it works. So there is a way of different way of treating, you know. We have also kind of what's called visualization to throw out the negative energy and to bring the positive energy like that. So many way there is a way to get treat.
Join us for our next episode, where we discover why Tibetan medicine is a sacred medicine.